Welcome to Mika Mode College Online Tutorial. We hope at the end of this lesson, you will have acquired the expected learning outcome. Sit down and listen attentively as we introduce your subject teacher.
Hello students, I am Mr. Salami EA. Welcome to physics class. The topic we have today is elasticity. Now what do we mean by elasticity? Elasticity is the ability of a substance or a material to regain its original size and shape after undergoing stretching or compressing. Then if you have any elastic material, the process, let's assume if you have an elastic material and you stretch it or you compress such material, the ability of such material to retain its original size and shape is what we call elasticity. Like the material we are having now, I am having before you now, is an elastic material. Why do we call it elastic material? Because if you stretch this material and release it, it will return back to its original size. You can see now, the length has been increased. Why? Because there is a force being applied on this. You see that what the length has been increased. That means there is an additional length on this. Why? Because there is a force applied on this. Then if you release this now, you discover that what it will go back to what? Its original size. Now, then this kind of material is what we call what? Elastic material. But the ability of this material to return to its original size is what we call elasticity. Then if you can see now, we said any material that retains its original size and shape after undergoing stretching is called an elastic material. Example, we have spiral spring, we have rubber band. We have so many of such a material. Then you look at what? Under the same elasticity, we look at Hooke's law. Then we say Hooke's law is a law that governs the relationship between the stretching force and the extension produced in an elastic material. Then when a force is applied to an elastic material, the length of the material increases by a certain amount. That if you look at this now, if force is being applied on this now, you discover that what the length of this material is being what? Increased. Then why the length is increased? Because there is an additional force acted on this. That is what we mean by what? Hooke's law. Yes. Then if the force is removed, the length returns to its former shape and size. This relationship between the stretching force and the extension is given by Hooke, which holds till a certain limit of force is reached. Then he now formulated his law called Hooke's law. Then the Hooke gave us what the relationship between the force applied on the material and the extension of such a material. Then after that, he now came up with his law, which we call what? Hooke's law. Then the law now states that the extension of an elastic material is directly proportional to the force applied, provided the elastic limit of the material is not exceeded. Like now, we have this now as an example of this of such material. Then if force is being applied according to the Hooke's now, then the higher or the greater the force applied on such material, the larger the extension of such material. That is what we mean by what? Directly proportional to the what? Extension. Then which means if there is less force applied on such, we also have less extension. That is what we mean by what? Hooke's law. Yeah, if you look from the law stated above, you will see the expression from that law. You will see F there, which stands for what? Force, and you will see E there, which stands for what? Extension. Then the sign in between the F and E there is what we call a sign of proportionality. Then that shows that what? Force is directly proportional. That shows that what? If you look at the F is here, you see what? E. And the sign in between the F and E here is what we call a sign of what? Proportionality. Then the F here is the force, E is the what? Extension. Then which shows that what? The force here is directly proportional to the extension. Then if you want to change this sign in the middle, the sign of proportionality to what? Equality. You must introduce what? A constant value, which is this k. From there you have your f equal to what? Ke. Where f equal to force, e equal to extension, k is constant, known as elastic constant. Or you can also call it a force constant or stiffness of the material. Then remember that the law can only hold when the elastic limit of the material is not exceeded. What do we mean by this? We are having this material now, which is what, elastic material. In the situation where I decided to increase or apply more force on it, then it will keep on increasing. It will keep on increasing. It will get to a point where what, when it's exceed this elastic material, what will happen to the material? The material will cut. And in the situation where the material cut off, the law will not hold again. The Hooke's law will not hold again. It can only hold when the elastic limit, the limit in which the what, the material will cut off, will not exceed it. Then if the limit is not exceeded, then we can now say that what, the Hooke's law is hold. But in a situation where the limit is exceeded, the Hooke's law is no more hold. Note that the practical work to demonstrate the relationship between the stretching force and extension of the material will be done when the school resumes. Now, from the law now, then once you carry out the experiment, what will happen? You get the force, you'll be given the mass, you'll be given from the mass now, you'll get your extension. Let's assume we have the first mass given to us here is what, 10 Newton. Then when the 10 Newton is being hung in the spiral spring, we discover that what, the original length of such material will increase. Then we discover that what, it increased by what, 2 centimeters. It increased by what, 2 centimeters. Therefore, when the force is 10, we have E to be what, 2. Then when the force is 20, we have E, which is extension, to be what, 3. When the force is 30, we have the extension to be what, 4. Then you have a column of force which is on the vertical axis, and we have a column of what, extension, which is on the horizontal axis. And the horizontal axis is your extension, while the vertical axis is your force. Then in physics, we don't deal with what, x-axis and y-axis. We deal with what, vertical axis and the horizontal axis. Depending on the parameters given to you or the kind of experiment you carried out in the laboratory. Now, what will happen here, if you plot the force against the extension, this is what we have as a graph. You discover that what, you have 10, 20, 30, and on the horizontal axis we have 3, 2, 3, and what, 4. Then you see, look at the what, the slope we have here now. At this particular point here, we have 10 and 2. At this particular point here, we have 30 and 4. Then which means the slope now gives us what, change in F over change in E. Change in F, that's change in force, all over change in extension. Then if you look at now, increase, what we mean by change in F, it means increase in force. Increase in force now at 10, and we also have it at what, 30. At initial we have 10, final we have 30. And when we have 10, what do we have as our extension at then? We have E, which is E. When we have 10, we have what, 2. And when we have 30, you trace it like this to the vertical, we have 4. Which means at 30 to the vertical, to horizontal axis, we have 4. At 10 to the horizontal axis, we have 2. Then change in force now, we have 30 minus 10. And change in what, extension, now we have 4 minus 2. And 30 minus 10, what do we have then? We have our slope to be equal to 20. 30 minus 10, we have 20. Then go to the extension, we have 4 minus 10, what we have then becomes what, 2. Then when you divide this 20 by 2, you have your slope. When you divide this 20 by 2, you have your slope. Then you discover what you have as your slope is 10. Then the unit of this slope now becomes what, 10 newton per meter. The per means the what, division. The per means division, that is division line here now. It means newton divided by meter. Then how do you get this newton here? Now newton is the unit of force on the horizontal, on the this one numerator side. Then it's the unit of this force. While the meter is the unit of extension. And when you divide newton by meter, we have it as what, newton per meter. The sign here raised to power minus one means what, pi. Then our final answer now becomes newton per meter. Are we okay? Now you discover that what we have here now as the slope is our elastic constant. If you want to get the elastic constant of this material I'm having with me now, then you'll be increasing the force, and when the force is increasing, the extension will also be what, increasing. Then plot that force on the vertical axis, and you plot the extension on the horizontal axis, the slope will have, after the whole things, which we demonstrate on the what, on the board here, then we have it as what, elastic material, elastic constant. Then you can call it elastic constant or force constant or stiffness of this material. And you see, if let's assume this is the material we use in the laboratory before we have this 10 newton per meter, then if this material we use, it means the elastic or the stiffness of this material is what we have as 10 newton per meter. That is that for that. Thank you for listening to me. That is the end of the today's class. We'll continue from where we stop when next time we meet. Thank you very much, and God bless you.